this for the chance to draw out Demetrious Johnson, Harrod Akhmatov, and Danny Kingan in the semi-finals of the one flyweight world Grand Prix. Southpaw star from the Cuban, the Olympic wrestler, Gustavo Balart. Orthodox stance on Wada, who's using a lot of the circle early on. Three-time deep flyweight world champion, Tatsumitsu Wada. Crowd here in Manila, electrifying for this one. Lots of excitement.
Is an Olympic wrestler from Cuba, and he's also spent a lot of time working with the Olympic boxing teams out there in Cuba, and now he's relocated to Miami, and so he gets some really good training partners out there in Miami as well. Tatsumitsu Wada likes to close the distance. He likes to take people down and put them on their back. That's what we saw against Kingad.
Wada continues to move around the circle here. Overhand left there from the southpaw Balart. Trip back to center circle. Balart so powerfully built. Racks that left hook. There's an uppercut from the Cuban. And this is the target. Love to see what happens if Balart shoots in, gets a takedown, puts Wada on his back. Or if Wada gets a takedown and puts the wrestler on his back. Inside leg kick from Balart. Overhand left from Balart. He is loading up on that overhand left. The rear hand of the southpaw. Balart comes after him again, hunting with that left hand. The power still with the Cuban. Balart certainly the aggressor early on. Wants to get on the inside, wants to land the power salvo. That left hand's cocked and ready.
Let's go. Inside leg kick, and he closes that distance, and there are the overhand left.
But it's cut over the left eye, it looks like. Already the damage inflicted by Gustavo Balart. The Olympic wrestler from Cuba. He's a three-time deep flyweight world champion from Japan. Jab from Wada. Good leg kick there from Wada. Fake from Wada. Lots of instructions coming from the Cuban corner of Gustavo Balart. Out Gladiator.
I'd like to see Wada use more straight, linear weapons, straight punches, to utilize that jab, at least start touching, you know, Balart, because Ballard's getting very comfortable throwing that big left hand. I'd like to see him start throwing push kicks right up the middle. There's some straight shots.
Good punch combination lands there from Wada, so to the left hook from Balart. Just didn't quite turn the knuckles in, the Cuban wrestler. 2 minutes remaining, first round of three. Quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Step up, side kick to the lead knee there from Balart. Wada angles, lateral movement. Balart wants to throw that left hook again. He can smell it, he can sense it on the Cuban. It's a high-lift roundhouse kick. He goes to the inside lead leg.
See, Wada's having a hard time with that range and that distance from Balart. Well, Balart's very accustomed to this type of differential, this type of range advantage. So you can start to see him, he's very comfortable jumping in and throwing these shots. They look like maybe a jumping switch knee followed by an overhand left.
It's all a striking contest in the opening round so far. Balart's edging forward. Powerfully built thighs on the Cuban. Shoulders, there's a high kick. The wrestler goes to the inside leg, high up in that femoral profunda. Overhand left from Balart. Threads the jab. Wada, the sweeper. Outside leggy from Balart, lifted the leg off the canvas. Goes a second bite at the cherry. Right hand down the tube from Tatsumitsu Wada. Cuts up it up a little more above the left eye of Wada. Wada calling Balart forward, wants to counter the Cuban. Overhand left there from Balart. Fake from Balart. Tracking right hand, smack bang on the kisser there from Wada. And Balart does a quick count of his teeth. Sticks out the jab, does the Cuban. Fakes and feints from Tatsumitsu Wada. Skip up roundhouse kick there from Gustavo Balart. Tries to get the inside. Wada just loses his footing. Into the round, we go to the towel. is loving. Gustavo Balart in Manila.
Is Balart getting airborne here as he tries to take Tatsumitsu Wada out as he jumps in with the switching kick, follows it up with a left hand. But then Wada starts to get a little bit more comfortable with this reach advantage that he's got and starts to put him out there. He starts to feel out Balart, and then he starts to throw those hands a little bit more aggressively. There's a straight right hand that touched up the face there of Gustavo Balart. Now, I'd like to see, I'm surprised at this point, to be quite honest with you, Michael. We barely even see any takedown attempts. This is an Olympic wrestler who is choosing to strike with Tatsumitsu Wada. It's a very interesting point at this juncture right now.
Second round of quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines.
Watch out
here,
okay?
Through to the semifinals to join Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson.
Guys, back, please.
Former
back,
world
back.
Champion Karat Akhmatov.
Right, ready?
Large opening a cut, inflicting damage on Wada.
Guys, watch out your head.
See, I think that headbutt, how Wada comes in like that, that's how the headbutt got opened up on his eye.
Wada with the jab. A Martin southpaw stance. Tried time and time again for the overhand left of the opening stanza. Inside leg kick from Balart, who has outstruck Tatsumitsu Wada, the three-time deep flyweight world champion. It's been said, very surprising. Like of takedown attempts from both men, particularly from Balart, given his career as a multiple wrestling champion and an Olympic wrestler back in the 2012 London Games.
But he's having a lot of success. He's having a lot of success here on his feet. You know, he doesn't feel maybe, you know, he needs to take, you know, Wada down, or he wants to take him down because he's so having so much success throwing that left hand and that inside low kick as well.
Is it difficult here for Wada? I mean, Wada's faced shorter opponents before, Mitch, but never someone 20 centimeters shorter. And having to punch down against Balart, does that pose problems for the three-time deep champion?
Well, Tatsumitsu Wada's game is, you know, to punch, close the distance, and then work for takedowns and get people on their back and start grinding them on the top position. You know, but so this is a very awkward style to punch down like this, you know, and he hasn't quite gotten comfortable with it. I'd like to see him throw more kicks.
Now there's a cut, it looks like, to the side of Balart's right eye.
See, I think that could be the headbutts. Because they're clashing heads. They're having a difficulty. Wada's rushing in, throwing shots, and they're
both of you. Last time, headbutt. Watch out. Okay?
Let's take a look at some of these headbutts, because I think it's not one person's particular fault. I think it's just the style that they're doing. You know, as Wada's coming in, he's trying to change levels maybe, or at least feint, and they're just slamming heads. I think it's happened multiple times. See, Wada's coming in, Balart ducks underneath to throw that left hand, and Wada is just slamming his head into Balart because of the height differential.
So it was Wada who was leading with his head on that occasion.
But I think it's happened more than once. I think that's like the third time that's happened. It's, you know, it's Wada slamming his head into Gustavo Balart.
Wada is allowed 5 minutes for medical examination here and recovery. He's okay to go on. You see some damage on both men's faces and foreheads. Flyweight World Grand Prix quarterfinal number four.
Ready? Two.
Between Gustavo Balart, the Olympic wrestler from Cuba, and the three-time deep flyweight world champion from Japan, Tatsumitsu Wada. Cracking roundhouse kick there from Wada off the right leg. Balart chasing him. Wada caging. Has experience. Has all the tricks in the book. While looping left hand there from Balart. Jump ball in the tap from Balart on the inside. Hooking off both hands now. More hooks than a Pirates convention for Gustavo Balart. Skip up roundhouse kick from the Cuban. Enjoying the striking tonight. High kick from Balart. No takedown attempts still here.
Watch out.
Gustavo Balart, out Gladiator.
He was trying to cartwheel kick there, apparently. Dropped down on his head. But again, they're clashing heads again.
Out of caution.
I don't think it's Balart jumping up and trying to headbutt Wada. I think Wada is the one coming down onto the headbutt.
It's Wada again coming down with his head, and that time it was a headbutt jaw. So it's Wada's jaw coming down on the head of Balart. I didn't see Balart's head come up on that occasion.
Yeah, it's not like he's jumping up trying to headbutt him. See, Wada's trying to change levels, and he's getting very tight, you know, in the exchange.
Ready? Two!
He has to change levels to try to match the height of...
Guys, watch out!
Gustavo Balart.
Yeah, Wada leading with his head.
Yeah, you see how he's crouching forward like this? He's trying to get nice and tight, nice and low. It's weird to try to see an athlete match the height of his opponent.
A jump hook in the jab there from Balart, the house on fire! Just got out of dodge in time to Tatsumitsu Wada. Balart again skips forward. That left hand's ready to go. Slings the legs. Wada looks for a counter. 150 remains. Second round of three. Scoops out the kicking lead to Balart. Makes that. Jumping roundhouse kick from Balart. Certainly the more active of the two is El Gladiador, Gustavo Balart of Cuba. Just popping right hand from Wada, overhand left from Balart, tries for the uppercut.
Balart's doing a good job of throwing that left hand and touching Wada. I'd like to see Wada throw more of the jab. It's right there. It's like his reach should be easily touched. Like he should easily be able to reach out and tap Balart in the face. But it's like Wada's waiting for the takedown, and that's why he's changing levels so low. So he can possibly dig for underhooks.
That is Wada's strategy at the moment. Causing Balart to be the one scoring on him. Balart the busier of the two. He's the impressor of the two. So, you know, Wada's letting valuable time slip away, but he's really not doing a lot here, Mitch.
There's a nice little right hand thrown by Wada that landed on the entry as he was coming in.
But then he didn't pounce on Balart. He had an opportunity there. To capitalize, to inflict more damage.
This is what I've seen in a lot of Balart's matches. Like the second round, he has a tendency to fade. He starts to get a little bit slower in his movement, not quite as aggressive. And this is where his, like, in his one loss that he has, where he got hit with a jump flying knee, he was getting picked apart on the feet that led up to it.
Southpaw stance on Gustavo Balart. Ryan's the roundhouse kick, looks for a left-hand counter. Final seconds of the second round. Good right hand, speed and accuracy there from Wada. Not so the overhand left of Gustavo Balart. One more round to go in quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix.
Here's Balart, Superman punching his way into the entry right there. And then I'm surprised not a takedown came. These guys are just choosing to stand and trade. There's that jab from Wada. See, it works when he puts it out there. But then again, he throws the punches, he circles out, he's gone. He's constantly dropping down, trying to get nice and crouched, which is an interesting strategy.
Inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines, will it be the Cuban Olympic wrestler? Or will it be the Japanese three-time deep flyweight world champion who goes through to the semi-final round? A magnificent quarter-final matchup brought to you this one by Global Citizen.
That's wrong. Watch out, okay?
Third and final. It is either man's for the taking. Who wants to dig down deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude?
Ready?
Ready?
Who wants to put the foot on the turbo chargers now, on the burners, and really light this one up. Right hand lead, and then Gustavo Balart backs off Wada.
Every combination, Wada is dropping his head down and almost trying to push off of Gustavo Balart. So he'll throw a shot, get nice and tight, drop his head down, and then push off.
Balart has not attempted, I don't believe, one takedown attempt. Have you seen one yet from Balart? This is surprising given the caliber of his Olympic wrestler. He's a multiple Critter Roman wrestling champion.
I'm surprised on a lot of different levels with this matchup, the way that it's going. There's a nice little knee from Wada. In every single one of his matches, up until that big knockout that Gustavo Balart got, he was taking people down and smashing on them. But now, the Olympic wrestler wants to strike. He had the feeling of what it feels like to knock somebody out, and I think that's what he wants now.
There is a lot of instructions coming from the corner of Wada, right next to our commentary position. He continues to circle the circle here. Balart connects with the right, not so the left uppercut. Roundhouse kick was a nice one from Wada. Balart jumping hook off the rear hand, haven't seen that before. Some inventive striking here from Gustavo Balart, El Gladiador. 3 minutes 30 remaining, third and final round for a place in the semi-finals of the Flyweight World Grand Prix.
I think the jumping is Balart's way to close distance. You know, he doesn't quite have the, you know, there's a nice little leg tap right there to try to get that knee in.
To phrase a term of yours, Mitch, at what point does Balart look to close the show and use what he does best, his wrestling?
I don't think he's gonna. I mean, he might choose a late stage takedown just to maybe score in the judges' eyes, but like, even then, he changed levels. He grabs the leg, but then he pops right back up. It's almost like he's just getting Wada to think about the takedown rather than actually attempting the takedown.
Spinning back fist and an uppercut from Balart. Came agonizingly close. The overhand right from Wada. Balart goes hunting, tips to the body, loops the left hand to the head. Uppercut, that one connected, chin through the top of the head. Gustavo Balart landing some leather now. Right hook, left hook from Balart. Another hook of the lead hand from Balart. Another hook of the backhand from Balart.
Now these guys are starting to trade. They've understood each other, exactly what the other person is going to do. And Wada's actually using this change in levels or this bending down as he's dropping his head to actually use it as some pretty good head movement.
Oh, stiff between the eyes, that right hand lead from Tatsumitsu Wada. 2 minutes 5 remaining, third and final round. Balart hooks him again off the lead hand. Overhand right to a left hook there from Balart. A high left roundhouse kick.
Now we're starting to see the experience.
Oh, takedown! Boom! Shakalaka! Takes the back!
The first takedown was a big one.
Belly to back here from Balart. Will it try to take it down again? The Greco-Roman champion, the Olympic wrestler.
And clutch.
He tried a second attempt at a takedown and jukes his way out with an uppercut.
Ooh, that takedown could have been that could have inched it forward for him in the scorecards, because up until that point, that third round was a lot of Wada right there.
Damage around the right eye, causing some problems here for Balart. Eats a right hand, the uppercut, the lead hook, the high check. 110 remains, Balart fakes. Wada again persisting with the right hand. But the three-time deep flyweight world champion is being backed up by a Cuban wrestler.
What a beautiful job out there on the scores. Look at that. That's three unanswered jabs by Wada.
Balart consistently, constantly wiping that eye. Jab.
Nice.
Nicely done from Wada at full extension. And I've got to agree with you, Mitch. I wonder why Wada hasn't thrown that jab all night long.
It's like they both sort of woke up in the third round to utilize their game plan or their strategy that they're supposed to do. Right up the middle.
55 seconds on the clock, and Wada taking an accidental strike from El Gladiador.
Man, I like those takedowns from Balart. I wish we could see some more of those.
Still one. It was thunderous.
Let's take a look at it. Is this one of them? Look at this. Boom, right up through the middle. Yep, that was it. Caught the jab, right with his face, right up the middle with his
okay. Damage to the face there of Balart.
Eduardo,
right,
hey,
eye,
watch out.
Some problems that you can't under the left eye. Wada glances to his corner. They're telling him to get a move on. Time is against us now.
That knee is landing. I think that's like the third or the fourth time that knee has connected. Right as Balart comes close, Wada's able to land that knee. Oh, nice two-punch combination there.
Final seconds of the final round. And here it is. We go down to the judges here in Manila. Arms his chest, does El Gladiador. They believe. they go through to the semifinals and join Mighty Mouse, Karen Akhmatov, and Denny Kingan.
But there's Balart just slapping Tatsumitsu Wada as he follows it up with a left hand, but then fake the takedown there. He gets it nice and tight. There's that left hand to the over to the high crotch, picks Wada up, puts him down, drops a little bit of ground and pound, but Wada, he showed the experience that only 30 matches can give you. And that time, that grinding in there, and he was able to inch forward a little bit in that third round until Balart was able to land that takedown. I'm interested to see how the judges saw that one. I would hate to be a judge right now. This is a tough match to score.
Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Tatsumitsu Wada.
Tatsumitsu Wada advances for the semi-final round of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. He will join Demetrious Johnson, Karen Akhmatov, and Denny Kingan in the final four. And he did it the very, very hard way.